First of all, Pastor Brian, before we get into this, let me just greet your listeners. Good morning. I greet all of you in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. Thank you for tuning in. And yeah, Pastor Brian, Lenny, driven, passionate,
nice.
You know, spontaneous.
Yes.
Sommige dingen begin voor nonsense. But most importantly, caring individual.
A caring individual. Sommige dit voor nonsense, but he's a caring individual. Hallelujah. Thank you so much that you could share, you know, who you are and what, you know, how people, you know, if you agree with him, please comment. If you know he's just a full nonsense person, please talk to us as a believer. As you recht te maken. Amen. So the reason why we have you here, sir, you know, there's a lot of things that we can talk about this morning. We are grateful for the fact that we are here to talk about your business because it is Thursday and we are here to talk business. What businesses do you have and, you know, how long do you have your business?
All right. To start off with, most people know Brad Pitt.
Yes,
is the business.
Yes.
Most people got to know
not the actor.
No.
But is the franchise.
Yeah. So most people got to know about Brad Pitt.
Yes.
They got to know me in business.
Yes.
Brad Pitt.
Yes.
But I've been in business prior to Brad Pitt.
Okay.
Very low key. Mm-hmm. You know, because you know. Those days I used to be in the 9-to-5 still. Yeah, the businesses are AcroPro Holdings. That's mm-hmm. a holding company. Then there's Brad Pitt.
Okay.
Yeah, those are the businesses.
Oh, nice. I think I also saw something about you in the government sector where you were working. It had to do with finances.
Yeah, correct.
Is it easier for you to now have a business since you have been handling other people's money? Is it easy to handle your money or what is it? Is it like that? Does it help?
No, you know, it's not easier, Pastor Brian.
Yeah.
It's more difficult when you handle your own money, you know.
Oh.
Handling other people's money,
yeah.
There's structures in place. There's discipline that comes with that. So
okay.
you can only operate within certain boundaries. So, but that also being said, it's more difficult dealing with your own money, having to
sure.
handle your own money.
I can believe so.
So yeah.
I can believe so, sir. So you know, the lowest moment that you can think of in your life, just as an individual,
yeah,
what helped you come out? Because we wouldn't have known Leonard today if you gave up 10 years ago, 5 years ago, 20 years ago. What was that thing? Can you speak about it? Can you encourage somebody and just talk about it?
You know, honestly, my lowest point in life was when I lost my grandmother.
Wow.
And this is over 20 years back.
Sure.
So that was the biggest turnaround
yes.
point for me. Yeah. Losing my granny was
mm.
was extremely hard. Because,
yeah.
you know, I don't have to go too deep into it.
Yeah.
Because, you know, that part of my life was what actually, the part that shaped me.
Mm,
you know,
mm.
the, you know, all that she instilled in me.
Yeah.
And I remember I was still in matric. From
yes.
standard 9, I had to take care of my grandmother, trying to be a, you know, a youthful person, playing soccer, wanting to be out on the streets always. But the most important thing was to make sure that before I could go home or to do anything else, make sure that food is on the table, cook, take care of the household, you know. So
mm.
losing my grandmother necessarily would have been
yes, yes.
The most difficult part in
yeah.
turnaround point for me. Yeah.
That leads me to the next question. So does it mean your father wasn't involved? Because grandmothers are always, you know, in the gap when our fathers are not there, or our parents are not really involved. Did you
yeah,
grow
yeah.
up with?
No, I grew up with a single mother.
With a single mother, yeah.
Yeah.
So wow.
my grandmother and my mother, you know,
yes,
that's
yes.
that. Those were the pillars. My mother's still around, thank
yes.
God. Yeah. But my
yes.
grandmother, losing my grandmother was the turnaround for me.
Sure, I can only imagine, man. So yeah, and I think she should be proud of you right now. Can you say that she'll be proud of you?
I hope that she's proud of me, but she is not.
Amen, amen. What inspired you to go into, was it like, have you always been in the bakery business, or was it just one of those things where you said, you know what, I want to build, doesn't matter what kind of business it is, I just want to run a nice business for myself.
Pastor Brian, I'm going to be honest with you now. Bakery, being in the bakery business wasn't part of the plan.
Okay.
Right? It has always been, you know, construction, but not like your normal construction.
Okay.
Being in business with guys like Rockla, your big players.
Yes.
In those years that I've mentioned earlier. still being in government. Mm. But the bakery industry, where we moved in, and this is where I'm going to bring in my life partner, mm. and also my business partner,
all right.
Rihanna Treasure, all right? You know, it started where we I think we had an incident in the community,
all right.
and we realized that there's a huge gap in terms of social responsibility,
okay.
in a particular area.
In the bakery business.
Yeah. So right. our you know, growing up in Tukiz, we know the dynamics of Tukiz. And we saw that there's a huge gray area.
Yeah.
And that's where, in terms of breads and all those type of things.
Yeah.
We had a bakery previously. I don't know who it was and what the name was. So when we had that incident, we got home and we were like, you know what? There's a particular social responsibility aspect in our community where people are living very, you know, below the breadline.
Yeah.
Excuse the pun. Yeah. Right? And we, as a social, for us, we, you know, it came from what can we do in terms of business mm. that will also help elevate our people.
Sure, I like that.
You know, and make a difference for people to be able to afford, you know, bread
yes.
and, you know, just to have something on yes. the table on a daily basis.
Wow.
So
and within walking distance.
You know, so wow. that's where Breadbud was born. So we sat and we looked around certain, it wasn't just the bakery.
Mm.
So we looked at what we could do as a social responsibility, giving back to our community.
Sure.
And God willingly, or thank God, the idea came up. We ended up, after scribbling on a few papers, to say, you know what, we actually need to feed our people. And wow. if feeding our people means that we can create jobs in a particular industry,
wow.
and also, you know, get a type of product where our people can easily, that our people can easily access mm. at an affordable price.
Wow.
You know, it's heartbreaking when, okay, this was the incident where people would normally come to you, hey, we don't have, I'm not going to name the person's name
yeah.
that actually, I'm struggling, my kids haven't had bread for a few days, you know, it's difficult, it's this, it's that. We know that dynamic. I mean, a lot of us has been, it's
yes,
been there.
Yes,
we've seen
yes.
it. You know,
like sorry, in my life, at some point, for a few years, bread was a luxury.
Exactly. So
sure.
that's where we realized that, you know what, if we could create this business in our community, establish this type of business in our community.
Yeah.
And it was, you know, as much as people look at it as a business,
yeah,
we see it as an opportunity to meet the needs of our lower class people, you know, the people mm. that are really at the bottom line of the mm. food chain. So that's where Breadbud comes from. And we thank God for bringing this to our hearts, you know?
That's amazing. Well,
so that's
I love the approach, because you didn't really go into it and say the last guy who had a bakery drove a 4x4, stayed in a double story house. You went into it and say, I want to solve a problem, something yes. that I struggled with as a young man. I saw the community struggling with it, and you went into it. How many branches do you have at the moment, and where are they situated?
Currently we've got three, thanks God. And we pray
sure.
for
three.
For three, yeah.
Nice.
We pray for growth. And the one is situated in Tukiz. That's the main one.
Mm.
We've got our second one, which we opened in 2 years back in
yes.
Mutlakeng.
Yes.
And then last year we opened another branch to serve the needs of our guys in Rangate.
In Rangate.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. That's amazing. And I had the opportunity to you know, to always use the one in Rangate. Because I always came, I drove to Tukiz to come and buy. You had a special anointing on your buns, my bro. I don't know what you do there. I literally stopped buying from Spar and Pick and Pay, because yours is different. Even Melitis, you understand? I will buy a 6-pack of those buns, and Melitis will make coffee, and there's a big cup that we have in a cupboard, not the normal size, a big cup. And I asked my 9-year-old, Jez, why does he always use that cup to make coffee
yeah, yeah.
and eat buns? He says it's because it's big enough for the bun to fit in when he dips it in the coffee.
Yeah,
that's how amazing it is. Wow.
Thanks a lot for that.
It's amazing. what happened through COVID, when COVID started, you're still open, you're still running, you're still operating, and the people that you employ, do you still feel that you are still solving a problem, or has it become too much for you at some point where you felt, am I really called for this business? What's happening? What happened to you?
You know, Pastor Brian, COVID is a very bad thing that could ever happen to humanity. But we're not going to delve into that now.
Yes.
Coming to your question is that, you know, throughout COVID, difficult times, because you know everything in terms of supplies.
Yes.
Everything in terms of pricing, there's an increase automatically because of the demand would automatically be more, but the supplies would be less. So that's why people, you know, so we managed to get through it. I also can share this, that, you know, I'm a COVID survivor myself.
It was
difficult having to go through that, and, you know, see my family suffer from me not being active. It was difficult, but we thank God that the business could operate in my absence. The amount of time spent, the sleepless nights that has gone into this business could afford me to be away from the business for 10 days.
Okay.
And, you know, because of the
the
discipline and dedicated teams that we have, the partner that I have, amazing partner that I have, you know. So it could afford me the opportunity to be away from the business.
What does it take for a person to still have 3 branches 4.5 years later? Is this for anyone? Or can you say, you know, what it took from you and what you gained over the past few 4.5 years?
Pastor Brian, you know, this is I love this conversation. You know, I would have this conversation with peers on the street at times when we do get this opportunity.
Yes.
You know, I'm glad I can sit here today. Grateful that I can share.
Awesome.
You know, a lot of times when, you know, anybody can start a business. I think where a lot of times we go wrong is that we I call them see-do entrepreneurs.
See-do.
Entrepreneurs. The reason why I say that is because we see and then we want to do. And that will never be a sustainable business.
Sure.
That will never be a business that grows, because the blueprint does not sit with you. You know, anybody can open any successful business at any given time.
Sure.
But you need to invest the time. You need to invest, you know, you need to do your research.
Yeah.
You know, in where you want to be. Planning is those are cornerstones. It's still. So up until this day, you know, you need to invest enough time.
Yeah.
Not time when it's daylight and people see Pastor Brian is sitting behind the mic. That's not the time to invest. That's not the time that you invest. The time you invest in your business is where people don't see you.
Yes.
That's the most important part of. If I can advise any of the entrepreneurs out there, is that, you know, invest enough time. Plan.
Yes.
Make sure that you understand where you want to be. Understand the market necessarily. You know, even by selling potatoes, Pastor Brian, can be a very beautiful, lucrative business if you just invest, plan. You know, invest not always money. That a lot of young guys that comes up and speak to me, they will ask me, hey, where can I get funding? Where can I get this? You don't need funding to run a successful business.
That's true.
The funding that you need is your discipline and your time, your dedication towards that business. Funding at some stage comes automatically because you put your brand out there to a certain, you know, to a certain level where people want to associate with your business.
Yeah.
And most of the time where we've gone wrong is that from the start, we want people to invest in our businesses, mostly financially. I would advise to say that change the way you think. Rather invest in getting your brand to a sustainable place,
yeah,
where funding follows you.
Wow.
And you don't follow funding.
Mm.
You know,
because you get frustrated.
You get frustrated.
Mm.
You have to. I can't emphasize enough, Pastor Brian.
Mm.
In where we you know, maybe the industries and you know, society has placed us in that place where we think that for me to be successful, I need to have a particular or an amount of money in my bank account.
Yes.
You know, that sustainability comes afterwards.
Okay.
Sustain yourself by investing time in your business.
Hmm.
Get your brand out there. So that when you do knock on any door, people would start recognizing you.
Mm.
You know?
Yeah.
I would just advise on that as well. So it's just the effort that you put in. I remember as Brad put, you know, when we started the Toekomstig branch, we used to sleep in the shop here in Toekies.
Wow.
Because we paid the school fees, I can tell you, and we still do. We're still learning. We don't know it all.
Yeah.
This industry is too big for us to can say that we've made it. No, we haven't. We're not even 30% at where we want to take this business.
Wow.
You know? We slept in the shop.
Serious.
When the electricity goes off at night, you know, you don't anticipate these things happening.
Mm-mm.
But because it's something that you learn, something that you invest in your time, your physical time. I cannot emphasize enough on invest time in your business.
Invest time
in your business.
How long did it take you to do your research before you opened the first branch, or did it happen while you started and you took it from there?
Pastor Brian, before we actually opened doors, I remember it took us about 3 months, 3 to 6 months in understanding the industry.
Oh.
Even to an extent where I studied a thesis on Albani.
Oh.
You know, why is it that these guys are the big players that they are in the industry? So for me just to come in, you know, our type of businesses are called hot bakeries.
Okay.
Right? That's and these are things that I picked up during my research of the industry.
Yeah.
You know, it this industry goes back many, many, many decades, right?
Yeah.
Where Albani started, this is what I did and this is what we got to do. And we did a proper breakdown of how do we fit into this market, you know. It took me about a month to properly understand the market. It going through the thesis. I remember the thesis was done by a guy from KZN.
Yes.
Over 500 pages, man.
Sure.
It was a lot. I can't tell you that I remember all of it.
Yeah.
But I think the most important part of it.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
And we try and implement what I've learned from there.
Yeah.
Into our business.
Into your business. Yeah. And does most of it work?
It works.
On your level?
It works. It
works. Okay.
It works, definitely.
Okay. Something I also want to ask you as I also want us to get real as we are about to conclude our conversation here. As a black man / colored person in this business, in this industry, maybe not necessarily in this industry only, but as a business person and in the locations where your shops are, you're not just selling from the shops. I know you spoke last time about, you know, you are contracted with a few companies where you deliver every morning a few sections in other areas. Is that an easy thing based on your background, based on your location and all that? What is the struggle there? What have you faced so far that you can say something that you can obviously speak about on air?
Yeah.
What have you faced so far that you can say, you know what, you didn't think it's that bad in this economy or in this industry industry or just business generally?
Yo, Pastor Brian, you know, we know this. It's difficult coming in as a young black person, colored person, in any industry, especially industry with this big players like your Albanis, your Sascos, all those guys, right? It's never easy. It's never easy. But like I said in the beginning, is that you need to invest and grow your business to a particular point where people start talking about you. You know, even the guys from Albany called us in once and said, but we hear, they've got people that live within our communities. Their employees live within our communities. So they speak about these things, you know, and I'm not going to divulge a lot of the information, but, you know, where they came on board and say, listen, what can we do? What can we do? How can we assist you? We see what you're doing, right? And but that's something that's still in the pipeline now. You know, it takes time for us to get to where we want to be.
Yes.
There's a lot of things, Pastor Brian, that I can speak about, man, in the struggles that we've had. But thank God today I can sit here and confidently say that, you know, we are one of the bakeries in the West Rand that's dealing directly with all suppliers of everything that we have in our shop, all our ingredients that we use in our shops.
Yeah.
There's no middleman. We speak directly to the manufacturers.
Sure.
And it's because of the time and the effort that we've put in to this business. You know, they recognize you and they want to do business with you.
Yeah.
Because your volumes, the way and how you conduct your business.
Yeah.
You might think that people don't notice. You might think that it's only the people within the community that understands and see your business. No, you'll be surprised how many people actually speak and invest time. Remember, they've got their own marketing people that goes to the communities.
Yeah.
You know, especially with this new community revitalization, business revitalization.
Okay.
That's economic revitalization. That's the correct term. That's happening now.
Mm-hmm.
So the big players are coming to the communities. So if your business is established at a particular point or in such a way that they have no other way but to speak to you, to say that, you know what, we see the pick and pays, the whatever's coming into the communities.
Yeah.
So our young entrepreneurs in the communities must start think around those possibilities to say that, you know what, if I am this business and I can see, that's what I'm saying, you need to invest time, Pastor Brian. So that if you don't invest time in this, you don't pick up those things. You don't see that actually, you know what, my neighbor is actually a big player that I can potentially partner with or get some mentorship from.
Sure.
You get what I'm saying?
So
investing time is a whole totally different conversation that I would love to have one day. These big players come into town. They want to be part of the township economy. The township economy of late is what's driving our economies. How many big players do we have in our townships?
Yes.
How many? So young entrepreneur out there, look at these things. Find your space. See where you can actually connect. You understand?
Besides the struggle, besides the rejection.
Build yourself to that point. So we are fortunate, Pastor Brian, because of the time that we and the effort that we've put in this. And I'm not even saying money. The money is something that comes afterwards. You know, they come and they speak to us to say, but you know what? We see these guys are supplying you. We of late, I'm going to mention this because it's been on my socials. Guys like Sesco coming to us and say, you know what? Let's have this partnership. Where we can supply you because of they've somebody told them about our quantity. Somebody told them about what we do, what we buy. You get what I'm saying? And we thank God that we could grow this business, and we are still working on growing this business even further because it will then create jobs for our communities. You get what I'm saying? So us growing this business, Breadpin, doesn't just benefit me and Rihanna tomorrow, you know, it benefits the community at large because more people can be employed in our communities.
That's true.
Because that is ultimately one of our biggest goals. We're standing on 40 permanent now.
Wow.
In by next year, this time I want to come search you and tell you I've got 80 employees that's permanent on our
and those are families. How many people are dependent on that one person?
Pastor Brian, that's where we're moving.
Wow.
That's where we're taking this.
And obviously they can take bread home, you know, as part of.
So most of the time people just see the business aspect of it.
Yeah.
They just see what we do in terms of the business.
Yeah.
Or this is what's on the front side. But the most important thing is what you do what when people don't see. That aspect, you know, behind most the curtain important. Type of scenario. That's where the business
is. That's amazing.
Is. That's where the business is built. Yeah. Not in front of the counter or in front of the shop. The business is built behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes.
And if
the sweat and the tears.
The sleepless nights. Mm. People don't see that. Mm. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And but we are committed to this cause.
Yeah.
We know where we want to go with this.
That's amazing.
God willingly, in the next few months, there will be new developments, particularly in Tukumtres.
Mm.
We know and pray that God will
yes, see it happening. And also we have other branches in other cities and so on.
That
komsterkan, hallelujah.
Ons werk hard.
Amen, amen.